is the day that the Lord has made. Shout for joy to the Lord, all the earth.
Let us bless the Lord and sing his praise.
Come to him with joyful songs.
The Lord our God is good.
His love goes on forever and ever.
His faithful love never fails.
Our opening hymn this morning is Come, Ye Thankful People, Come. Satisfied. but often ignore the cry of the poor and hungry. Lord, in your mercy,
forgive us and help us.
We are often thoughtless and do not care enough for the world and its people. Lord, in your mercy,
forgive us and help us. Our God, who is both power and love, forgives us and frees us from all our sins. He heals and strengthens us by his Spirit, that we might be fruitful in the work of his kingdom. Amen.
And we all say together the harvest prayer.
Creator of fruitful life, you made us heroes of your creation. Give us grateful hearts and help us to bless those we need, as we remember how blessed we are this day. Amen.
First reading today is from Paul's letter to the Philippians, chapter 4, beginning at the 4th verse. Rejoice in the Lord always. I will say again, rejoice. Let your gentleness be evident to all. The Lord is near. Do not be anxious about anything, but in every situation by prayer and petition, with thanksgiving, present your requests to God. And the peace of God, which transcends all understanding, will guard your hearts and your minds in Christ Jesus. Finally, brothers and sisters, whatever is true, whatever is noble, whatever is right, whatever is pure, whatever is lovely, whatever is admirable, if anything is excellent or praiseworthy, think about such things. Whatever you have learned or received or heard from me or seen in me, put into practice, and the God of peace will be with you. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Please stand for our second hymn, We Plough the Fields and Sky.
Thank you.
Spoils, but for food that endures to eternal life, which the Son of Man will give you, for on him God the Father has placed his seal of approval. Then they asked him, what must we do to the works of God require? Jesus answered, the work of God is this, to believe in the one he has sent. So they asked him, what sign then will you give that we may see it and believe you? What will you do? Our ancestors ate the manna in the wilderness, as it is written, he gave them bread from heaven to eat. Jesus said to them, very truly I tell you, it is not Moses who has given you the bread from heaven, but it is my Father who gives you the true bread from heaven. For the bread of God is the bread that comes down from heaven and gives life to the world. Sir, they said, always give us this bread. Then Jesus declared, I am the bread of life. Whoever comes to me will never go hungry, and whoever believes in me will never go thirsty. Give thanks to the Lord for this his glorious gospel.
Praise Christ our Lord.
Let us pray. From seed time to harvest, we give you thanks, O Lord, that you are the God who watches over us. You are the Spirit who works within us. May we indeed produce good harvest for the glory of your name. Amen. Please do be seated. We have to rejoice in the Lord always, and again Paul says, rejoice. And our harvest celebrations are to be a time of rejoicing. I did a quick search using one of the Bible apps and got told that there's over 110 different mentions of the word harvest within our scriptures, Old and New. In our Old Testament, it's about instructions to keep a celebration, to rejoice that the harvest time has come. We have to bring in the first fruits of the harvest, and at the end of the harvest there is to be also be a great celebration that the harvest has come. In Genesis 8 verse 22, in the time after the great flood of Noah, the Lord promised Noah that he would never again completely flood the land. And he says, as long as the earth endures, as long as the earth endures, there will be seed time and harvest. There will be cold and heat, summer and winter, day and night will never cease. And so we rejoice in God's great creation. That marvel that we are in what's known as the kind of Goldilocks zone. We live in a place that is close enough to the sun to benefit from the sun, yet we're far enough away that the sun doesn't burn us up. We're an M-class planet, if you're into Star Trek and all those other things. We're a planet that can sustain life and bring about life, and as scientists are sending out more and more probes out into the world and into the creation, there's this marvel that there's, you know, there are other possible planets that could be able to sustain life. But so far, amazingly, we still haven't found any. I think that's actually a sign that there is intelligent life elsewhere in the galaxy that has decided to keep itself quiet away from us. We have to rejoice in the creation, the way that God has created. Even today, enough food is produced in the world to feed the ever-increasing population of the world. Yet 7 million tons of food is wasted in the UK alone. We are not poor. We are not starving. And in many ways, in our modern life, we're detached from the seasons of creation. We enjoy strawberries when there's frost in the ground and it's cold because they're flowing in from somewhere else in the world. We've detached ourselves from the rhythm of life. And God in the Old Testament gives us instructions about how to farm. He tells us, you know, that we have to, in some ways, rotate our crops. And that there's to be fallow years, so there's years that we grow produce from one part of the field, but then in year 7 we have to let it grow fallow to recover. We're told we've not to harvest to the edge of our fields, but to leave the rough bits at the edge for the creatures of the earth and for the poor and the needy, so that they can harvest and have food to eat. But of course, with the industrialization of farming, we can now get rid of all our hedgerows and create bigger and bigger fields. And we can harvest right to the edge. But thankfully, if you've been watching Land or other programs like that, we hear that some farmers are returning, replanting hedgerows, leaving fields fallow once more, because they've found that in our greed and our hunger to yield more crops, we've actually affected the ecosystem, the balance that God provided. So the Old Testament talks about harvest, gives an instruction to the farmer of how to look after the gift of the earth. But when we move into the New Testament, the harvest becomes like a metaphor for the end of time, the end of life. Jesus often tells his parables, the farmer sowing a seed, and then an enemy comes and sows the tares, and both grow up side by side. But one day they will be harvested in, and there'll be a separation. We have to be those good seeds, focusing on whatever is pure, whatever is true and noble, whatever is right, whatever is lovely. We have to grow like a seed, abundant, producing good crop. And through putting these things into practice, although we grow up next to things that we struggle with, wars and man's inhumanity to man, by growing up and being a better example, we seek to change the ecosystem, to make God's presence more visible in our communities. Harvest, we celebrate all that we've been given, but we also look to that final harvest, when the bread of heaven, who has been given to us, will call us to our heavenly home. Jesus says that he is the bread of life. It's good to feed on good food. We all need it to survive physically. It nurtures us. It enables us to be strengthened with the energy for the daily task. But much more do we need to feast on Jesus, to remember the love of God given to us in Christ. The good news that we are loved, that God has not only provided a planet that can sustain life, not only provided us the food that we need for our daily lives, but has also provided the food that we need for eternal life. In Christ our Lord. Amen.
Please remain sitting or kneel as Pat comes to and does a prayer of intercession.
So to Lord of the Harvest, the response is, hear our prayer. Lord of the Harvest,
hear our prayer.
Generous God, at this harvest time, we thank you for all that you provide for us. As we think about the food on our tables, let us remember all those who do not have enough for even one decent meal a day. We pray for the homeless and for those who depend on the charity of others. So we pray for the work of the local storehouse and the volunteers who support the local food banks by providing food for those in need. We pray that the harvest of crops, fruit and vegetables that we receive from all parts of the world will be shared more fairly, so no one should go hungry. We pray for your guidance in the way we manage and care for this planet with its rich resources. Lord of the Harvest,
hear our prayer.
Father God, at this harvest time, we thank you for the hard work of all who grow, process, prepare, and transport our food. We ask you to watch over those who at sea bring in the harvest the sea provides in sometimes hostile weather. We pray that you keep our farmers safe when operating heavy machinery in all weathers. Bless all those who live in some of the poorest countries in the world. Do not earn a fair day's pay for their hard work, producing food for export, for our enjoyment. So help us to buy not only local produce in season, but also fairly traded goods wherever we can, so that all who provide our produce can work with dignity. So we continue to pray for the reduction of poverty in countries experiencing hardship because of climate change. Lord of the harvest.
Amen.
Mighty God, so often the lack of justice throughout the world concerns us. We hear of parts of the world where the end to wars and civil unrest seems impossible. We continue to pray for the end to the war between Russia and Ukraine. And we pray for a solution to the destructive war between Israel and Palestine and the huge losses sustained in these countries. We pray for all who are being driven from their homes in so many countries and are therefore forced to seek refuge in Europe. And so we pray for the member nations of the European Union to do their best to offer a safe refuge to those in need. And we pray for a solution to the thousands who risk their lives to cross the dangerous seas in unsafe crafts. Lord of your harvest, Creator God, we thank you for the world we see around us, for the miracle of changing seasons, for the leaves of the trees beginning to show off the colours of autumn. Help us to protect your creation by being careful how we use our resources, so that our water will always be clean, the air unpolluted, and there will always be plenty of bees, birds and insects to maintain the ecological balance of our countryside. We give thanks for all that is good in your creation, Lord of the harvest.
Amen.
Loving God, at this harvest time, we ask for your blessing on our families, friends and neighbours. For those who are sick, we pray for the disillusioned and depressed, and all who have lost their way in life. We pray for comfort to those who depend on others for their needs. Remember in our prayers the members of our congregation who have recently been bereaved, or for those who are suffering in any way. Be close to them, that they may be aware that you're always there to help them through the difficult times. In our prayers for others, we hold before you all who have taken the time to walk around St. Mary's during the opening hours, and have entered a prayer request in the book made available. May they take comfort in the knowledge that we are offering prayers for their loved one, and that they may receive a feeling of sense and peace and the love of God. Christ Jesus, who is the living bread, we pray for people who are walking in the darkness of discouragement. At harvest time, we thank you for providing for our physical needs. But we must remember to share the bread of your word that brings light and hope to many in need of your message of salvation. Lord of the harvest, faithful God, we thank you for this time together in worship and prayer. And as we look forward to the week ahead, we pray for an awareness of your love and support in all we do. Continue to bless and inspire our clergy team and deliver them from discouragement and exhaustion. Give them the strength and energy to fulfill the work you have called them to do as they minister to the needs of the people in our two congregations of St. Mary's and St. Mary's. Therefore, merciful Father, we ask that you accept these prayers for the sake of your Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Amen.
Please stand. We meet in Christ's name, for he is the Lord of the harvest.
Let us share his peace.
Fairness and sorrow is great in my thankfulness, O God, my Father.
Great is thy faithfulness, great.
Yours, Lord, is the grace, the power, the glory, the splendor, and the majesty. For everything in heaven and on earth is yours. All things come from you, and of your own being. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
And let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give our hands and ears.
Worship and praise belong to you, Father, in every place and at all times. You made us all the people of the world and everything that is. You bless us with a fruitful creation and give us the seasons of life. From springtime to harvest, we praise you, O Lord our God. As our world changes from one season to another, through the great cycle of springtime and summer, autumn and winter, we praise you, O Lord our God. As citizens of your kingdom, we join our praise with all of creation and the heavenly realm, singing the song of your unending glory.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
Please do feel free to sit on the list. Father, you never forget us, or turn away from us, even when we fail you. You sent your Son Jesus, who gave his life for us. He healed those who were sick, cared for those who were poor, cried with those who were sad. He forgave sinners and taught us to forgive. For all your love, we give you thanks. We praise you, Lord our God. And we remember that on the night before Jesus died, while he was having supper with his friends, he took bread and offered you thanks. He broke the bread and gave it to them, saying, "Take, eat, this is my body, broken for you." After supper, he took the cup. He offered you thanks and gave it to them, saying, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant. It is poured out for you and for all, that sins may be forgiven. Do this in remembrance of me." We praise you, O Lord our God, and declare that Jesus died and rose again to live now in us. Lord of the harvest, send your Holy Spirit on us, and on this bread and this wine, that they may be the redeeming symbols of your sacrificial love. Amen. The living bread is broken for the life of the world. Lord, unite us in this sign. And as our Saviour Christ has commanded and taught us, we are bold to say, Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power and the glory, for ever and ever.
For God so loved this world that he gave us the gift of his Son, like a seed. That love of God is planted in each of us to bear good fruit as we remember his love in Christ our Lord. Come, for all are welcome at his table.
Thank you. Give thanks to the Lord, for he is gracious.
God of the harvest, nourished by your love, may we continue to grow and bear fruit of the Spirit, and a blessing to all in our community. In the name of Christ our Lord. Amen. God, give you grace to be faithful stewards of his creation, to be people of faith, hope, and love. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, be upon you and remain with you, now and always. Amen.
Can you please stand for our final hymn? We seek your kingdom throughout every sphere.
You might not know the words, but I'm sure you'll know the tune. Abide with me. appreciation and thanks to all those who have helped with the decoration of the flowers and the harvest loaf and that. It's looking lovely. Thanks and appreciation. Our harvest gifts, which have been collected in, will be passed on to the local storehouse to be distributed locally to those in need. We draw your attention to the shoebox appeal. It just feels like it gets quicker and quicker every year. So we're collecting the items for the shoeboxes. You're welcome to make a shoebox up yourself. I believe there are some make your own shoeboxes, flat pack shoeboxes, for those who struggle to find a shoebox. And you can fill those. Sorry, John? I know, that's why we're offering you flat pack ones. Oh, Andrew's demonstrating. You're not demonstrating how to put it together, you're just holding it up. And there are shoebox leaflets there as well. And these have to be collected in by the end of October so they can be checked and shipped out to those in. On the back page, we're having a Scotch-Ukrainian concert. I think when you tally it up, I think we've got about 8 different Ukrainian families now that we're kind of connected with. And so we thought it'd be nice to have an evening where we celebrate some Scots culture. I'm hoping that's whiskey and haggis. And some Ukrainian culture and with songs and an evening, hopefully, to look forward to. So that's on the 15th of November as well. There are other notices there, but there's no need to underline them yet, I think. Anything else? Have I forgotten anything?
Pet blessing.
Oh, there's a pet blessing this afternoon. If you're a bit of an animal or you've got a pet, come along at 3 o'clock and there's a pet blessing service.
It's a goldfish.
Even if it's a goldfish. Its memory is probably better than mine. So do stay for some refreshment if you can before we go in a short time of fellowship.
Please stand. The harvest has been gathered in. Now go in peace to love and serve the Lord.
In the name of Christ. Amen.